It's the Ron and Fez Show, live on 106.7 WJFK, live on a Thursday. Ron Bennington, Fez Watley with you.
Fez, I want to move on, but Bobby has a theory here that I think you need to hear. Bobby, you're on the Ron and Fez Show?
Go ahead, Bob.
What's up, Ron? What's up, Fez? All right, Fez, you said you're terrified of flying in planes, and you're freaked out by even holding someone's blood in your hand in a jar, by body fluids, things like that.
Sure.
Are you generally freaked out by stuff that's kind of extraordinary? Because, I mean, there are a lot of people who are freaked out by the human body, not because they don't understand it, but because they understand the fact that it's so amazing that these things are, like, they overthink it, and on a subconscious level, it freaks them out. That's why a lot of Nobel Prize winners right now became priests, because it's just so amazing the more you know about this stuff. And maybe that's why you're a little freaked out, because,
you
see how amazing it is.
You're right, Bob. You're right in the thing where I don't like anything too extreme in my life whatsoever. I like to stay the course. I like to have a pattern. I like to have a schedule.
What is it about normal for you, though, Fez? Why can't you be there for the precious? Why can't you be right there in your own life? You know what I mean?
No.
It's like you're not showing up for the miracles. For a guy who likes the idea of spirituality, you're not present for the miracles of life. The babies being born. The precious blood that we all need.
A lot of that weirds me out.
A mother's milk.
Ew. I don't need to be involved in mother's milk
to be above the clouds.
To enjoy the miracles of life.
But listen, every miracle that came up, you're standing back from. And then during the commercial break, you were telling me the excitement you had about having pushpins.
Yes.
In the new office.
Yes, I'm going to get a bulletin board and pushpins for the office.
Couldn't you push pin some mother's milk then?
No, I couldn't. Not whatsoever. Maybe I enjoy my miracles from a distance.
Do you like to be around death?
No.
Do you like to have something die in front of you?
No.
Something be born in front of you?
No.
You just want to be in the gray area. You don't want to be any of the extremes.
Right. Yeah. Keep it nice and safe right there in the middle.
But is it safe, Fez?
It feels safe.
Is it?
You know what? I just thought of this with the baby being born thing. I remember when I was little, I used to have to come home from school, and the key would be under the mat because there was nobody home when I got home. And I just remembered this happened to me, I think, when I was like 7 years old. I came home, I unlocked the door, and I went inside, and the cat had kittens all over the place. And I remember running from the house screaming, scared to death about that. No one was home, and there was these little bloody kittens everywhere. And I think one of them actually had its little placenta still on it.
How old were you at the time?
I think I was like 7.
And when you think about that now, how does that make you feel?
Weirded out, grossed out, running, scared.
Scientifically, Fez, you would be called a pussy. But what
that is not a scientific term.
Yes, it is. It's in the mental health area. What I believe is that this gentleman really came up to something that we need to do with you. We've got to get you in the extremes.
I don't need any extremes.
We got to get you mountain climbing. Get to the top of something.
Why would I want to go climb a mountain?
Would you rather be in one of those small submarines that goes down to the bottom of the ocean?
No, not with my ears. The pressure.
Maybe we could get you into a hospital to watch an open heart surgery take place.
I would not want to watch that. Boy, I've tried to watch some of those things on the health channels or whatever. I can't watch like those knee surgeries or anything like that.
All right, here's a good one for you. Our friend Jaster is going in to get his knee scoped this week. And he needs a buddy. Would you go in with him?
No. I'm sorry, Jaster. I like Jaster a lot, but I can't go watch his knee get scoped.
It's a deal, then. You'll go in with Jaster and watch his knee get scoped.
And how is that going to help me with anything?
I don't know. But that's the chance I'm willing to take.
How is that putting me on the edge, watching someone's knee
surgery?
Look
how you feel right now. Are you on the edge?
I feel like I'm running from the kittens again. Make the kittens stop.
That's a beautiful thing you witnessed.
I didn't know what it was. I was freaking out. I thought the cat had died. I thought all the kittens were dead.
What a puss.
Cat.
All right, Jafter, actually just IM'd me. He's in. You can go in when he gets his knee scoped.
I am not going in when he gets his knee scoped. That is sick. I don't want to watch that. I wouldn't watch it if it was my own knee getting scoped.
Fezzy, can I call Mikey D in here?
Yeah, you can call Mikey D in.
Come on in, Mikey. I don't know what's happening right now with Mikey.
Mikey's upset, angry, all the bad emotions. All right, here he comes. Here he comes. Harry Alvis, sit on the phones. Not literally. Him and his dad will try to sell him.
Oh, by the way, Pantera says that he gets grossed out if somebody puts their finger in his belly button. Can you, Fez?
I don't think so.
You want Harry to put his finger in your belly button?
I don't think I'm like giggling already. I don't think that would... That might weird me out if it was Harry.
What if he wets his finger first?
Oh, that would really gross me out.
Now here comes Mikey.
Hey, Mikey.
Hey.
Hey.
Mikey, I can't live like this.
I didn't do anything. I've been answering the phones. Phones are good tonight, right?
Jeez. Look how he's treating me.
I'm not treating you anyway.
You're immediately coming in confrontational. Like you're ready for a fight.
I'm sorry. I'm not trying to be that way. So what's up, guys?
Mikey, I want you to know from the bottom of my heart that music thing was Cameron.
That's fine. You know what? I'm never going to mention it again. That's no problem whatsoever.
It's just the opposite. I'd rather we were all up front, and today was a bad day. And I tried to talk to you up front.
That's fine. No, really. I'm really, there's no problem with it.
You tell me to take back the election from last night, and you got it.
Because no, that's fine. It was a fair Democratic, convention, election. That's fine. That's cool with me.
It's not cool, is it, Fez?
It doesn't seem cool, Mikey. It seems like you're trying to say that now to make us feel good or just to get out of this or something.
No, really. I think everything is all right. You know, Ray's doing a great job.
Oh, you're just saying
no,
that.
No, I'm not. He's doing,
lying.
He's doing it. He came in here. He's been running the board. Everything's
fine. You know,
earlier
today you said I'm going to have this out on the air and you just couldn't do it. You know, Fezzy, for you, 7 o'clock, by the way. Tuesday morning, you and Jafter.
No, I am not going Tuesday morning with Jafter.
He's got to know that we care about him. Do we care about Jafter?
Yes, we care about Jafter.
And anytime...
And I want him to have good knees.
Anytime any of our listeners is going in for an operation, Fezzy will be there.
No, I won't. I'll be as far away as possible.
Here is... Carl's got something to say to you, Fez.
Hey, Carl.
Carl.
Hey, Fez. Hey, Ron. How you doing?
Yeah. Good, buddy. What can
Fez,
we do for you?
I think the problem with your bodily functions is you realize when you see all these bodily functions happening, you realize that we're mortal, and it brings you closer to your own mortality and that you're afraid of death.
Well, I don't know if that's so much true, but you're right about the part of being scared of death. Yeah, that's definite.
Trust me, I am too. I'm scared to death of death. But
I was just thinking today. I was just sitting there on the computer working on some stuff, and I just thought to myself, how will I die?
You know,
and it just comes up out of nowhere.
I honestly believe it'll be at my hand.
I always think about how you're going to die, Fez.
All right. People don't need to be concentrating on that thought.
But, no, you know what? It's weird. When my wife had my first book baby, I was absolutely thought I was going to be sick, and it was the most incredible thing I've ever seen.
Yeah,
and it changed my opinion about life. Up until I saw the big plastic tub with the placenta in there about an hour later,
sure.
Then I almost got sick.
Yeah,
it was an amazing
experience. I was so happy when my kids were born that I took that placenta and I put it over my head like a shower cap.
Really?
Mm-hmm. As a way to feel as one.
Wow. I actually ate my second daughter's placenta. It was good.
I just thought you said your second daughter. And I was going
to
dump that.
There was more to it.
All right, thank you, Carl.
Thanks, Carl.
You think you could eat a placenta, Fez? The Indians believe that brings you spiritual energy.
No, there's no way I could eat a placenta.
Are you afraid to die?
Yes.
Because of what? Because it'll just be blackness and there is no heaven, there is no God?
No, I think it's the, I don't know if it's the right word, is the finality of it all? Something like that?
Then it's all over.
Yeah. Maybe I just think I'd be missing stuff here.
It'll all be gone without
I think
you.
I would miss Earth too much.
You miss the Earth so much, you miss your wife. Because if this makes you feel any better, I know for a fact that when you die, it's total darkness and a falling feeling.
A falling feeling?
Falling backwards.
For how long?
Ever.
Oh. I don't like falling. You know me.
Heckler has a colostomy. How's that?
Colonoscopy?
I can never say that. A schedule, and he'd like you to go in with you.
No, I'm not going. Oh, God, I'm not going to watch Heckler's colonoscopy.
You can't go in for Jafter, not for Heckler. It's going to start trouble.
I'm not going in for anyone's knee or anyone's ass. And I hope they don't get the scopes mixed up.
Wonder Boy, is there a reason that you're hanging around?
Yeah, guys, I'm sorry. I just wanted to say that I feel really bad about the way the Mikey situation is going right now. No, Mikey, this is the thing. It really has been bothering me all night. And I wanted to let you guys know that I think it would just be better if I stepped down and take myself out of this position, because it was supposed to help everybody do better, not make somebody more upset. So I think it would just be better if I just took myself out of that
if
role.
If you wait another 50 seconds, you'll have had it for 24 hours.
I mean, unfortunately,
agree.
It didn't go as well as we wanted it to, and I think that, you know, I feel like stepping back would be the best thing I can do to help the team, Mikey, which is what I want to do.
No, I think you should stay where you are. That's fine.
But, Mikey, this is the thing. I feel really bad about this.
Why? Why should you feel bad?
Because you're not talking to me, and we were friends until this time yesterday. We were friends.
That's true.
Well...
And I would say close friends. I consider you a close friend.
Consider it.
Right. And the stuff that happened was this silly election that I want to remove myself from.
It's not the election that happened. Not at all. You see that? You don't even know. So who cares?
Right? I care. Then what was it?
It was because you stabbed me in the back. You sang these things, you know, to the guys. You know, I'm surprised Elvis didn't come in here stabbing me in the back saying that I was on the phone saying goodnight to Lene tonight.
But, Mikey,
you know?
No,
that's what you guys are doing. And then Billy's telling me that you guys are talking about me behind my back. So I don't need
that.
But
where is Bill? Where even is Billy?
Billy told me that yesterday.
All right, but Billy's gone. This is the weirdness of all the guys. All right? And Fez and I have tried to sit in here and do a show tonight.
Well, I don't want to be... This does not need to be on the show. You know?
It does. The thing is about radio, you do a lot of times what you're thinking about. This is on everybody here's mind. Mm-hmm. And we have to address this before we can all move on. I would not talk about you behind your back.
You do.
I admit I'm snotty and sarcastic.
Yes, you are.
That's for sure.
I admit that.
And I've said that since the day I met you.
Yes, and you're right. And I never said you weren't. But, Mikey, the thing is I would never talk bad about you behind your back. You know that. I was telling you yesterday how much I admire you, I respect you.
That was before the show.
But, Mikey, it's true, though. It's true before the show. It was true during the show. It's true after the show. I have not a bad word to say about you.
Geez, let me take the tapes tomorrow and I'll listen to. Oh, here comes Harry. Let me listen to that impression of me that you did right in the.
I'll tell you right now.
Right
you
there.
Heard me do that same impression of you.
Yeah, but
you
that's
have.
To me. You know.
You're gonna. So you don't want them to put things on the air.
No. I don't.
And you know what, Mikey? I got that tonight. When you didn't want to put the tapes on anymore?
I want to put the tapes on. I don't want him to listen to it.
I know. But I remember the old Mikey and what always used to be fun and all, and I don't want to ruin that. You know?
And by the way, Billy's an effing liar. He was just trying to create more trouble yesterday. No one talks about, you know, you behind your back. We never say anything bad about you behind your back. Mikey, what can I do to repair this between
nothing,
the two of us?
That's it.
Mikey, why would you believe Billy? When did you start believing Billy?
I've never believed Billy. I don't think his name's Billy.
No, Billy was just some confirmation, let's say, because I knew that these guys were saying these things. They were saying it in front of me.
What did Billy say that they say?
That you better watch out what you say behind, because they're talking about you in the control room.
All right, but what are they saying? What's Billy claiming that they're saying?
That was it. I mean, he didn't say that he was saying anything specific.
So he had nothing. He's just saying that we were talking about you behind your back, which is a lie. We weren't. Mikey, you know full well I adore you. I think that you're terrific on the air. I think that what you've done for the show is beyond impressive. And I told you yesterday that I was telling the guys that. If you call that talking behind your back, then I was doing that. But I told them that if I can work in this business as long as them and have someone half as dedicated as you work for me, I'd be as proud as a peacock. That is not talking bad about anybody. That's saying I wish I could have a staff that's as dedicated and talented as you are. Why is that a bad thing?
I don't think that's a bad thing.
Well, why would I follow up some kind of comment with that with something negative against you?
I don't know. I just don't even want to talk about it, really. I don't even want to, like, you know, look at you guys right now. So, I mean, I'm pissed off.
Is that me and Festo?
No.
Because I get the feeling it was me and Festo.
No, it's not. If it was you... You know, I
kind of felt that way, Mikey.
When did it feel that way? Tell
at the
me.
Beginning of the show.
When you're like, I don't even want you guys to you'll be, see what's on the tapes. And I'm like, why can't Mikey just say what's on the thing? And I know it started with Cameron changing the music. I know that. Every day was a good day before then. All this time was a good day every day.
No, it really, you know what? It really has nothing to do with Cameron changing the music. It really has nothing to do with that. All right? It has something to do with the fact that I got bombarded last night by these two guys, and I've been bombarded with by these guys. And then, you know, it just, you know, and then I'm supposed to just forget about it. And believe me, guys, I'm looking at Fez and I'm looking at you, Ron.
Right.
I have nothing against you guys. Maybe it's just my overall attitude, but there's nothing.
Yeah, it all started before last night, bro. It started about the time of the music.
But, I mean, as far as the diaries, I mean, I'd love to do it. Just put me in the room and I'll do it for you guys. You know, I just don't want, you know, maybe I said it wrong in the first half hour tonight, in the first segment. I don't want Wonder Boy. I don't want Ray to listen to the stuff. That's all. That's my main thing. Because he'll probably edit it in a way that it's going to make me look bad, and I'm not going to do that. I'll do it, and believe me, there's plenty of funny stuff on that those tapes without editing.
I honestly don't want the tapes.
Anymore. Okay.
Mike, it's silly for you to just let,
What are you, a woman?
No, it's just, I don't think the last couple of days should dictate how everything went, because up until then, everything was fine, and then all of a sudden, it's a 180 where now we can't even talk to you. You know, and
you're talking to me.
Mikey, when do you think, I mean, because we've noticed this for a while now, and like Ronnie said, it all seemed to start when Cameron changed the bumper music. When do you think it started, or what do you think the reason is?
Of what?
Of why you're so upset. You're not the old Mikey.
Mikey Day, everybody's buddy. Happy Mikey.
You were always one of the most joyful people around.
I don't know. Couldn't tell you.
You don't know why it went bad or when you think it went bad?
No.
But you don't think it's the Cameron and the bumper music thing?
No.
It's not then? Before then?
Was it a fight with El Jefe?
No way. El Jefe's nothing. Well, you know, El Jefe means a lot to the show. I mean, to me.
You're saying that's not the...
No.
That's inconsequential.
Yes,
why you're upset.
Absolutely.
Is there something else going on with you you don't want to tell us?
No.
Something going on at home?
No.
It couldn't have been all last night. I think last night is where it reached its boiling point. But it seemed to be more than just last night.
I don't know.
Is this really the way you want to end things? I mean, it was, you know, why go out like this where we're fighting? You know, it's...
Well, you guys want to go out in a blaze of glory, it seems, so you're doing
glory,
a good job.
Mikey? What blaze of glory? What was... I mean, it was all part of things that just happened, and they all came to a point, and, you know, if I thought you would be this angry at me and this upset where you wouldn't be talking to me, or, you know, where I'm trying to, you know, ask you something, and you know...
You asked me something. What did you ask me? You asked me for a Pepsi, and I said
If
no.
you wanted a Pepsi,
and, I said
and
no.
then, you know, you... flew by me angrily, and then you
How do you know
the bathroom
I was angry?
Door.
Oh, so
the
see,
the
there we go.
Door open,
I kicked the bathroom door open. That's so there we go again, telling everything that I'm doing outside.
See, but you want everyone to... You're asking me why I know you're angry. That's how I know you're angry, and...
You're obviously angry, Mike.
You know, to sit here and pretend you're not angry is... It's only, you know, it's not fooling anyone. We all know that you're upset about it.
didn't kick the door open.
I know something weird happened when Wardy left and...
Rory.
When the music got changed.
I don't know. I don't want to bring the show down now. I mean, you know.
I thought the show was brought down all night.
I thought it was a great show. Had some great topics. A lot of people calling in. Good stories. Good contest. You know I tell you the truth.
I don't know.
But there's more to the show than just what happens on the air. You know, that's part, you know, that's part of it. But if things aren't right off the air, it's going to eventually, you know, affect the on-air portion.
Who's the bigger problem for you, Mikey? Is it Ray or Harry?
Well, they both recently have let me down. That's all. Just with certain things that they said. There's always, you know, you can always rib each other and have fun and all that, but, you know, one, it's like...
When did it turn serious for you, then?
No, I mean, like, the other night, Elvis is giving me jokes to say to El Jefe, and then he's turning around and then saying, and basically stabbing me in the back again against that. Now, again, it's not the El Jefe thing that made me mad. That's the fact that nobody, you know, you guys didn't stand up for me, man. You know, and then you just continue, and you continued. So that gets to me. I hold grudges.
It was ribbing, you know, it was just... A lot of it was done in jest, and if I knew you would take it so deep, you know, to heart, I wouldn't have done it.
Here's the thing. You're going to go to jail for these HUD crimes.
Hopefully.
Yeah, that's for sure.
I want to tie up all my loose ends before I go, you know.
Shut up.
Why don't you tie up all your loose meat sandwiches? So, Ray, and here's another thing about you, Ray. Did you call Tammy today and bother her?
I called Tammy to give her my email address. Yeah, I left her a message.
Tammy and Promotions.
That's the last news that I heard from Billy, that he got boxed out by you with Tammy, and then he didn't show up tonight.
Well, he said he wasn't sure if... Last night he literally closes with your mom's box, which means to me that he may or may not be coming back. In all likelihood, he's not. So I just figured, hey, in case he's not here, it would be good if Tammy would send me stuff in case there's things I need to give to you guys. It wasn't like a thing where he's doing it to hurt Billy's feelings. I'm not even sure how Billy would have found that out.
She called him.
Oh, well, I didn't mean to overstep my bounds. I had been talking, and after we had our meeting on the air last night, I figured, well, my email address would be something good for Tammy to have. I didn't say, hey, listen, everything goes through me now, or please disregard your previous chain
of
command.
Obviously, you did.
What I said to her was, I said that I wanted to make sure that I had copies of the things that she sent to you guys, just so that way we had one extra copy of it.
Then why would she call Billy? She's busy.
Yeah, I'm not completely sure. And, you know, I'll apologize if I overstep my bounds there with that.
Hey, Mikey.
Yeah.
Does this have anything to do with the band?
No. No, the band's been rehearsing. We're doing good.
The RonFez.net band.
No, the band's been pretty cool. I just feel bad that I haven't dedicated more time with them, you know, sometimes. You know, sometimes we take too many weeks off. And,
That stresses you.
No, I mean, you know, it stresses me because they want to do a gig, and I'm not a person that wants to play out to an audience. And even though most of the time, most of the audience is drunk, you know, it doesn't really make a difference. But, you know, I still want to sound good.
You're a perfectionist.
Yeah, that's what I am. That's basically it. You can, you know, you can rehearse so much, but you've got to rehearse enough to, you know, at least be decent.
So that's not a source of stress for you?
No.
Would you rather me not be here?
No.
Does that make this easier for you? Because I don't really want to be here just being annoying to you. It's hurting everybody.
You're not annoying
me.
I'm
saying this. I'm all for Wonder Boy leaving.
No, you're not annoying.
Would that make it better, Mike?
No.
Because I'd be willing to do it. I want to make sure that the show is better than any of the individuals on it.
Nope. You're a valuable part of the show, man.
Mikey, I understand how you feel. I mean, if you're not willing to, you know, forgive and forget, that's fine. I just want to let you know. I mean, we don't have much time left, you know, where we're going to be close. At any point, if you feel like letting me back in, you know, I'd be more than willing.
What does that mean? Back in what?
In
what are you talking about?
Into his good graces. You know, like if at any point where he decides it's...
When you're out with Mikey, you're out.
Well, I mean, I hope that's not true because, I mean, I think everything...
Look at him. Instead of just looking down at your hand, look at him. You hurt him so bad that you're out.
I didn't mean to hurt you, Mikey.
What?
I didn't mean to hurt you. You know, I maybe did... Maybe I stepped... I went too far. You know, I was maybe thinking selfishly of trying to, you know, get an extra laugh that went a little too far. And if
well,
I did
extra
that...
laugh? You don't even get one laugh, Harry.
Before you start dealing with extras and leftovers.
When you were judging that contest today, I wrote down a notch for every sentence that you said without getting a laugh. And then covered both sides of a paper.
That contest was not my finest hour.
When is your finest hour going to be?
I've had some moments. I haven't had a whole hour.
When you're beating rent control?
But I think we're getting off course. I just, you know... I really feel...
Mike, you look so wired right now.
You look really, really upset. Are you upset with Billy, too? You have no problem with Billy?
It's got to be me and Fez. Or one of us.
Is it me?
No.
And that makes it me.
I would love to know what's got you hurting so bad. Because you know Ronnie and I care about you.
I don't know.
And something is breaking your heart, and I can't imagine that it's totally these two lunkheads, Harry, Elvis, and Ray.
And don't buy into anything Billy says, you know, that happens. He's just trying to spread propaganda, and he's just trying to bring us further apart.
No, it's just, you know, maybe it's just... You know, with Wardy not being here and...
Rory!
Rory, sorry. You know, I guess I miss him. I don't know.
If it means anything, he doesn't miss you.
I'm sure he doesn't.
Miss any of us.
I send him an email.
Calls him all the time.
I send him an email. He doesn't email me back.
No.
So.
The kid's got a stone heart. And as far as Billy goes, I'm going to quote you something from Tombstone. Don't mind him. He's just drunk. Take a break.
Sorry.
You don't have anything to be sorry for.
Wrong fashion.